decades, we've been hearing and talking about the Metro Man, that is Delhi's Metro Man. But here in Mumbai, we have our very own Metro Woman. On the occasion of Women's Day, while we of course talk about and feature women who are very successful in business, in the corporate world, the fact is that running and executing a large project, a developmental project, is perhaps even more challenging. And today in this exclusive interview, I'm speaking with Ashwini Bhide. She's of course Managing Director of the Mumbai Metro Corporation and Additional Municipal Commissioner of the BMC. So the Mumbai Metro Line 3 and the Coastal Road is something Ms. Bhide is going to deliver to the financial capital of this city. Thank you so much, first of all, speaking with us here on NDTV Profit on the occasion of Women's Day. I'm not going to start with a cliched question of how does it feel to be a woman IAS officer, because I'm sure in most cases it's the same as a male IAS officer. But to spearhead such big projects with the backdrop of political headwinds. So when you have a business, you have, you know, risks. Here in the case of such large infrastructural projects, the fact is that there is a plan, there is a goal, but you don't know what's going to happen in the next election. Is that the biggest challenge?
Yes, I think uncertain or uncharted challenges is something which is, I think I would term is at the biggest challenge. Because the project of this size, they already come with some inherent challenges. The size is huge, you have to implement these projects in a very, very crowded city like Mumbai. You need land, you need money, you need to convince people, and you need to actually take the risk related to construction and deliver the project safely. But these challenges are chartered challenges. You know what exactly this is going to be and you plan for it. But in these kinds of projects, there are many uncharted challenges which you have not anticipated. And dealing with them is one of the most difficult things, I would say. And we have faced many such challenges in this project. And that is something which, you know, you have to decide on the spot what you need to do about it. And sometimes they get dragged. So how to come up with a solution, that becomes the most challenging thing.
RA Metro car shed was the biggest one. It became, I think, a cause for environmentalists.
Yes, that I would put it in this uncertainty box,
but
that
you,
kind
you,
of challenge.
You became sort of painted as the person who wanted to push it through and didn't care for the environment. How tough was that?
It was absolutely tough, but once you know what your goal is, then probably it is easy to deal with that, because having a car depot at RA for this metro line is what makes that metro line really efficient and which can provide real service to the city. If you remove the depot from that area or that end of the metro, then the project completely loses its significance and importance. So if that is the importance of that location at that of the depot, then it was my duty to fight for it and ensure that the project is delivered to the city in the manner it was planned for. And that is why, but that time we had never thought that we will have that kind of an opposition from those sections of the society, because the procedure was already followed, everything was laid down. So this was some kind of an uncertainty which we faced, and we had to deal with it, and I had to take that tough stand, even at the cost of my personal kind of the problems which I had to face.
So you paid the price for that stand. For some time you were removed from the metro project, then you were brought back. All those uncertainties continue. How challenging then is it to now get back on track and ensure that this project, which is very, very crucial to Mumbai's transportation structure, is delivered on time?
There has already been a delay of almost 2.5 years to 3 years.
Because of RA?
Because of RA. Because that decision was pending, there was a stay for that location. And unless you have the depot location fixed and start working on the depot, it becomes very difficult for the rest of the project to get completed and get delivered. So my challenge when I went back was to how to reduce that time within which we could complete the depot and deliver the project. Normally, depot would take 2 to 2.5 years to complete the depot of this size, but we had to reduce it. We have to reduce the number of months which were required for the depot and ensure that the mainland and depot are connected. Because the depot was not there, our trains were partly ready at some other location, but they were not able to be brought here. So all those issues were there. Everything, all problems were revolving around the depot. So my job was to minimize those project, push the depot in the maximum possible manner, which we have tried to do. And now the depot is almost ready. Depot connected, the depot charging is happening as we speak. Mainland, the main line is getting connected to depot. Our trial testing has started, and we are hopeful that in another 3 months, when we complete all our testing and certification, RDSO certification, ISA certification, and CMRS, so by end of May or early June, the project will be ready for commissioning, and it will be offered in the service of the citizens.
Okay, so by June, July, maybe yes, we can, you know, actually see this come to life. Now, why is this Metro Line 3 important in the larger picture?
This Metro Line 3 is one of the most important corridors of the overall Mumbai's Metro Master Plan. But the importance of this project is this is the only corridor which connects the northern and central suburbs of Mumbai to the island city. This is the only corridor which comes to island city. All other metro corridors like Line 2, Line 6, even Line 7, they get connected to this corridor. Mm. Similarly, other public transport modes like the Central Suburban Railway, Western Railway, as well as both the airports, they get connected to this corridor. And that is why this is the corridor which goes into the areas which are today largely unconnected by any public transport, and these are the areas where there are multiple business districts and employment centers, educational hubs, and even health hubs, the medical hubs are situated. Mm-hmm. And people need to take this route, but by using multiple modes of transport, which takes longer time for their journey, and most of the times they have to travel on roads which are extremely congested, so their journey time is not only more, but the comfort and safety is also compromised. So this corridor provides the safer, more comfortable, and more modern kind of connectivity to all these congested areas of Mumbai. Mm.
Now comes the cliched question, because we are speaking on the occasion of Women's, yes, Day, and the fact is that when many people see, and you know, our audience, men, women alike, I think, see a strong officer who is manning a big project, it is inspirational. So explain to us whether you had to face some challenges because of your gender, how you overcame them, and what is your message for people who sometimes feel that things are tougher because they're women?
Yeah. It is my fortune that I could work in urban infrastructure sector for past 15 years almost. Before that I was in MMRD, and that time it was a new sector, and then of course I took responsibility of Metro 3. So while working in this sector, I had certain strengths, because by being the member of Indian Administrative Service provided me some strength. But my biggest challenge initially, which I thought, that getting accepted as a women leader in a men's world, mm, because predominantly it's a men's world, that was first I thought that was my biggest challenge. But later on I realized that wasn't, because I was easily accepted. Another biggest challenge of mine was I hardly knew anything about this sector. I come from a generalistic service, and I was handling many other departments before I joined here. So this was a completely new sector. And so I thought whether I would be a right kind of leader or not, because all others are the experts in that sector while I am not. But that I dealt with in the way the people actually accepted me, because it works both ways. They accepted my leadership, and that gave me an opportunity to learn most of the thing. So I always remained a keen learner and a team leader. So it was basically, I never thought that I am leading them, but it was the team which was I was leading, and this team was the team of experts. So a lot of things I learned from them, but I also provided a completely different and out-of-box perspective to them, because If you are an expert of a field, you have a certain kind of a thought process.
I came from
the outside sector, so I could join many dots which they couldn't see. Mm-hmm. And in fact, jointly we worked so efficiently that many technical issues which couldn't get actually implemented on the ground for non-technical reasons. So that I could give them a solution, they could come up with more efficient strategy to implement that. And this is how the projects, when I joined, most of these projects were non-starters when I joined in MMRDA. Mm-hmm. And that time, along with this team, which was a great learning path for me, but also for them also, it was something which they learned from me. So it was a very good give and take, I would say. And that is why, though I thought that these were the challenges, but actually they could be easily dealt with by having this team approach.
एक successful woman achiever से बातचीत होती है तो ये सुनने को मिलता है कि एक male से compete करने के लिए मुझे double काम करना पड़ता है, अपने आप को prove करने के लिए. I might be as good, लेकिन मेहनत मुझे डबल करनी पड़ेगी ताकि लोग माने आई हैव टू बी बेटर. ये आपने एक्सपीरियंस किया?
ये इनडायरेक्टली एक्सपीरियंस तो होता है. मेरे केस में मुझे थोड़ा एडवांटेज, जैसे मैंने बोला कि आई बिलोंग टू अ प्रीमियर सर्विस ऑफ द कंट्री, सो उसके साथ कुछ एडवांटेजेस आते हैं जो नेचुरली आते हैं. मे बी अ कॉमन वुमेन, इवन इफ शी इज़ वर्किंग इन अ वेरी हायर पोजिशन, उनको जितने नहीं आए उनको शायद ज़्यादा कठिनाई आती होगी, वो मुझे थोड़ी कम आती है. बट फिर भी प्रूव आपको ज़्यादा करना पड़ता है, वो तो है. क्योंकि बार बार ये किसी के भी मन में होता है कि अरे ये जिम्मेदारी अगर विमेन है तो ये चीज़ें उनको बताई जा सकती है कि नहीं जा सकती है, ये काम उनसे होगा कि नहीं, उतना टाइम वो दे पाएगी कि नहीं. ये शुरू में काफ़ी सारी इस तरह के डाउट्स लोगों के मन में हो सकते हैं. तो आपको, यू बिकम वेरी कॉशियस ऑफ दैट, और आपको ऐसा लगता है कि हम जो काम करें वो इस तरह से करें कि ये काम में कुछ ये वुमेन होने के कारण कुछ कमियां रही है, ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए. तो थोड़ा सा मेहनत ज़्यादा करनी तो पड़ती है.
व्हाट इज़ द मोस्ट आई वुड से सेक्सिस्ट क्वेश्चन यू फेस्ड? डिड समवन ट्राई टू मैनस्प्लेन टू यू अबाउट अ प्रोजेक्ट विच यू ऑलरेडी नो, और आस्क यू थिंग्स लाइक तो आपके बच्चे क्या करेंगे घर पे? ऐसा कोई सवाल कभी
होते हैं? इनडायरेक्टली होते हैं, बट आई डोंट थिंक ये सवाल मुझे जिन लोगों के साथ मैं काम करती हूँ उनसे नहीं आते. दे एक्सेप्ट यू एज इट एज यू आर एज एनी अदर ऑफिसर. आई मीन द जेंडर डजेंट मैटर वेन यू स्टार्ट एक्चुअली वर्किंग अलॉन्ग विथ योर टीम. ये जो सवाल आते हैं ना, वो काफ़ी सारे उस सेक्टर से नहीं होते हैं, ऐसे काफ़ी सारे लोगों के साथ आते हैं. क्वेश्चन तो वो तो कि आप कैसे घर संभालते हो और ये कैसे करते हो, तो आपके आप बच्चों की तरह कैसे ध्यान देते हो. अब ये सारी चीज़ें हैं कि कोई एक इंडिविजुअल, ओनली वुमेन डजेंट डू ऑल दिस थिंग्स. यू हैव अ हाउस एंड घर के सारे जो मेम्बर्स हैं वो उस प्रोसेस में पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं. बट अगर किसी के मन में ये एक स्टीरियोटाइप है कि ये सारे काम हैं वो जो महिला है उसी ने करने हैं, तब उस तरह के लोग ये सवाल पूछते हैं.
एक बात सही है ना, आप सोचिए आप पूरा मेट्रो संभाल रही हैं,
लेकिन
आपसे पूछा जा रहा है आप घर कैसे संभालती.
तो ये होता है, बट आई थिंक ये लोग आते हैं कि जिनके मन में ये इस तरह के थोड़े से स्टीरियोटाइप्स होते हैं वो लोग पूछते हैं. एक मेरे सर्विस में, मैं जब बहुत मेरी शुरू वाली पोस्टिंग में, मैं इचल करंजी में पोस्टेड थी, और वहाँ पे एक कुछ थोड़ी सी लॉ एंड ऑर्डर सिचुएशन हो गई थी. तो देर वॉज़ वन पॉलिटिकल पार्टी, लोकल पार्टी, उन्हीं के लीडर्स आए थे एंड ही स्टार्टेड टेलिंग मी समथिंग, हाउ दिस इज़ टू बी हैंडल्ड, हाउ दैट इज़ टू बी हैंडल्ड. मैंने उनको बोला कि नहीं, मुझे पता है मैं क्या करना है, मैं करूँगी, और मुझे ये सब आप बताने की ज़रूरत नहीं, आप अपना काम कर दीजिए. और फिर वो थोड़ा सा हमारी बात हो गई कुछ उल्टी सीधी, और वो थोड़े से गुस्से में चले गए. जाते समय मुझे बोले कि अरे आप तो एक महिला अधिकारी है, तो आपको मदद करने के लिए तो ये सब मैं कह रहा था, अगर आपको नहीं चाहिए और आपको करना है तो आप कर लीजिए. मतलब उनका पूरा ये था कि आई लाइक इट्स अ पैट्रनाइजिंग काइंड ऑफ एटीट्यूड, कि मैं आपको महिला अधिकारी को ये इस तरह की सिचुएशन शायद हैंडल नहीं कर सकती है, तो आपको मदद करने के लिए ये सब मैं कर रहा था. और जब मैंने उनको बोला नहीं, आई एम एन ऑफिसर, डोंट लुक एट मी एज अ वुमेन ऑफिसर, तो इस तरह के बहुत सटल चीज़ें होती है, ऐसे डायरेक्ट तो मुझे कोई ये होगा नहीं है, बट देर विल बी हंड्रेड्स ऑफ सच एग्जाम्पल्स वेयर सटली पीपल ट्राई टू इम्पोज द स्टीरियोटाइप्स इन देयर माइंड ऑन यू एंड ट्राई टू एक्सट्रैक्ट सम काइंड ऑफ वाइनिंग फ्रॉम यू कि नहीं ये बहुत ही कठिन है ये दोनों करना, इस तरह का कोई एक्सपेक्टेशन होता है कभी लोगों के साथ।
तो आप यही इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट है हमारे व्यूअर्स के हिसाब से, व्हाट इज़ योर एडवाइस व्हेन यू हैव दिस सटल काइंड ऑफ यू नो पेट्रनाइजिंग अप्रोच लाइक यू सेड दैट ओ यू मस्ट बी फाइंडिंग इट सो टफ बिकॉज यू आर अ वुमन ट्राइंग टू पेंट यू एज अ अबला नारी, हाउ डू यू रिस्पॉन्ड टू इट?
आई थिंक यू शुड जस्ट इग्नोर इट, इग्नोर इट एंड जहाँ पे आपको पॉसिबल है उसको रिटॉर्ट कर दीजिए यू, मतलब बिकॉज दीज आर नॉट द क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू, यू स्टार्ट कंसिडरिंग यूर सेल्फ एज एन इंडिविजुअल इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ योर जेंडर, और आपकी जगह पे कोई भी मेल कलीग भी होगा या आप होगे या फीमेल कलीग होगी, वो उसका जो बिहेवियर एज ए ह्यूमन बीइंग एज एन इंडिविजुअल होना चाहिए। बीइंग अ वुमेन यू शुड नॉट हैव सम अदर काइंड ऑफ एट्रीब्यूट्स एंड आई थिंक दैट यू शुड मेक वेरी क्लियर एंड अपना काम बहुत कॉन्फिडेंटली करना चाहिए। कभी कभी हो सकता है एज ए वुमेन आपके कुछ वीकनेसेस आपको प्रोजेक्ट भी करने पड़े क्योंकि फाइनली इट्स अ डिफरेंट जेंडर, बट डोंट फील गिल्टी अबाउट इट, ये आपका एक नेचुरल कोर्स में एक इंडिविजुअल जिस तरह से काम करेगा जिस तरह से आगे बढ़ेगा उसके मार्ग में जितनी भी कठिनाइयाँ होगी उसको जिस तरह से डील करेगा वही हमने करना चाहिए। वी शुड नॉट ट्रीट आर सेल्फ स्पेशली एंड वी शुड नॉट अलाउ अदर्स टू ट्रीट अस स्पेशली, दैट्स व्हाट आई फील यू शुड, इट शुड बी अ जेंडर न्यूट्रल काइंड ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट विच वी आर सेल्फ शुड प्रोपोगेट एंड दैट्स व्हाट वर्क्स बिकॉज स्लोली इस तरह के सवाल जो है ना वो कम हो जाते हैं फिर।
When they see a tough response, the questions end. But one question I definitely want to ask you is about the coastal road. We spoke in detail about the metro project and that's huge. The coastal road is another one which is now near completion, not without its share of controversy also. Do we need a coastal road? Is it environmentally viable? Is it right to... And all of these questions came. They, in fact, were in the public forum. Yeah. You know, you had to answer them. The whole government had to answer them. That at the end of the day, is it worth the money of the exchequer, the taxpayer that is going? Now, when it's near completion, will it really change the traffic situation, the face of Mumbai? Will this 10-kilometer or 10.5-kilometer road be the change?
It will certainly contribute to the change which the city is trying to envisage or see, because Mumbai had a limited road network, about 2,050 kilometers only, and so many vehicles ply on it. Naturally, we need to expand this network, but Mumbai being a coastal city, being a peninsular city, being because of its geographical shape, there are limitations in enhancing or expanding this road network. So coastal road provides a complete addition to the existing network. Normally you see the existing roads are getting widened, but here it provides a completely new connectivity. It functions as some kind of a marine ring road which provides a fully access controlled road and a faster connectivity to the city. So yes, its cost is slightly higher if you compare to the public rail-based public transport project, but it also serves a larger purpose for a city like Mumbai, which is already gasping for land, because this particular coastal road would reduce traffic time from 50 minutes to 10 minutes between Marine Drive to Worli, and that itself will reduce the burden on environment because there will be less pollution, there will be less air pollution, there will be less noise pollution, more space would be available. Additionally, coastal road, because it is built on a reclaimed land, there is some incidental reclamation, and because of that 70 hectares of new area is being added to the city, which is fully going or getting dedicated to landscaped gardens and recreational spaces. So I think from that perspective, coastal road is really beneficial to the city, and now the coastal road will get extended up to almost up to Virar. So that provides an very, very efficient high-speed connectivity to the city, which a financial capital like Mumbai and very, very highly congested or I would say with more highest population density, the city with highest population density needs that kind of connectivity.
So, you know, whether it's a coastal road or it's Metro Line 3 or any large development project, there are always questions on part of environmentalists and the environment, and perhaps the intentions are good,
yes.
You know, but my point is that what is your response? Because on the one hand, global warming, pollution, all of that are real issues. But on the other hand, you need this development as well.
That is true. Another point is this development comes with a level of environment. It is not that it is not a mindless development. The way the projects are planned, they are planned taking all environmental aspects into mind. But most of the times in our argumentative society, these features of the project are always kept at the hiding and they are not projected. When we plan coastal road or even metro, so metro itself is a green transport because it saves so much of fuel from burning. Metro line 3 itself will reduce 6.5 lakh vehicle trips from the road and that much fuel consumption will go down. So this rail-based metro projects are always considered as green projects, and that is why Government of India doesn't even ask them to get environmental clearance. They are that environmental friendly. A road like coastal road would always, people will argue that this will give impetus to more vehicles on the road, but there will be also a dedicated bus lane on that metro. So it will give further encouragement to public transport. And roads would anyway, in the process of development, connectivity is the key. Without connectivity, you can't reach from one place to another. And unless you do these kinds of projects, where will there be a faster or efficient connectivity? And without connectivity, there will be more congestion on the road, more vehicles on the road, and that itself will be environmentally detrimental. Mm-hmm. So these projects, they are planned with lot of after planning or taking into account lot of environmental issues. A detailed environment impact assessment is done for these kinds of projects, and even during construction, multiple measures to curb the impact on the environment are taken. In fact, mega projects are far better positioned considering the environmental impact than any other smaller project. But what happens, because of the visibility, most of the times environmentalists talk more about these projects, which are actually required for the city, which are done in the most environment friendly way, and they get a backseat. Whereas thousands of small projects keep happening without giving due attention to environment. And that is something which the environmentalists also miss, and that is something which the public discourse also misses. So I think we need to take things in its perspective. The long-term impact of any project, and that needs to be taken into account. And besides, had that project not been there, what would be the situation of the city, what kind of problems citizens would face, and what would be the net impact on environment, that also needs to be seen.
Last question for you, ma'am. So now coastal road is expected, Metro Line 3 is expected, the average citizen sees the whole city dug up one way or the other. When is the face of the city going to change?
With coastal road and Mumbai Metro Line 3 happening in 2024 itself, that the South Mumbai's traffic would definitely get far better regulated than what it is today. In suburbs, there are some other metro projects which are going on, and they are also in the process of getting completed. So maybe another, if we look at completion of Metro Line 2 or Metro Line 4, and then all these projects getting connected to each other, it would take another couple of years. But they will, everything will get slowly completed in a phased manner. And coastal roads extension, which is happening right now, that would take maybe another 3 to 4 years, because we have to go up to Meera Bhayandar and even Virar. But by then, metro network is getting completed, so a lot of traffic will get absorbed by the public transport system, and then people would feel lesser pinch of the other ongoing road works. So I think another 3 to 4 years, Mumbai's transportation scenario is Mumbai is poised for a larger change or transformation in its transportation scenario, and which is on the way.
So the pain and the wait is going to be worth it, and of course this is the officer who's making it happen. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much,
Ashwini Bhideji, for speaking with us. Thank you.